all those people, Trev. Gone and put it on video even. But it means a lot that you did it for me.
What the fuck are you talking about?
I am not the girl you cheat on.
I've gone through everything. We're definitely good on timeline.
Oh yeah. We're perfect.
No, 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 please.
My technique on the fourth, it'll be pretty similar to what I've been doing for the last 8 years. I'll be eating two pieces of meat and two buns. The buns I'll be dunking in water while I'm eating the meat, and I'll dance the food down. I'll dance it down and close my eyes and find my rhythm and do the same thing over and over again and just be that machine that doesn't stop. I can tell when there's something wrong, when my throat's not working quite right. And I have to change my technique, either use a little bit more water on the buns. It's not like I'm thinking, oh, this is number 45, number 46 right here. No, it's not at all like that. I'm just trying to do the same thing over and over again. And I have a general idea. And towards the end of the contest, I can feel, I know what it's like to have 60, 70 hot dogs in me. So it's I know where I'm at towards the end just by how I feel.
Well, that technique has worked very well for Joey Chestnut, including the 2013 record.
I mean, Joey Chestnut's hot dogs, 69, amazing, obviously. But the fact that Joey did all of these big numbers, 69, 68, 68, in the 10-minute era. It used to be a 12-minute era when he would battle Kobayashi, so the DPMs are unbelievable.
It is now time for George Shea to bring the eaters onto the platform and for the program to begin.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Bunettes and the Bun City Dancers. Bun Boy Nation.
Yes.
Are you ready? Are you ready? Ladies and gentlemen, in his rookie year, he is already ranked number 24 in the world. From Nigeria, now residing in Morrow, Georgia, he's eaten 34 ears of sweet corn, 6 feet, 9 inches tall. Let's hear it for Gideon OJ. From Dixon, California, 6 feet, 2 inches tall, ranked number 14 in the world. He's eaten 10 pounds of boysenberry pie. He won the Lincoln, Nebraska qualifier. Let's hear it for Steve Hendry. He struggles to understand the nuances of our culture. The difference, for example, between a butt dial and a booty call. But he understands everything there is to know about competitive eating, and he's widely acknowledged as a tamale eating specialist. 50 and one half tamales in 10 minutes. From Wichita Falls, Texas, the great Nasty Nate Biller. Ranked number 12 in the world, from Cleveland, Ohio. 6 feet tall, 200 pounds. He's eaten 31 Nathan's Famous hot dogs and buns in 10 minutes. Jeff the Beastman Butler. He was gifted at birth with a flawless memory. In fact, he can remember exactly what he was thinking at this precise moment 20 years ago to the day from today, 20 years from now, which is right now, it's today, it's the second, obviously, so he knows what he's thinking. He's thinking, why am I here listening to this guy? I could be in the Hamptons. Ladies and gentlemen, from Visalia, California, Pablo Martinez. He is the lumberjack breakfast and French cut string bean eating champion of the world. He was buried alive under 60 cubic feet of popcorn, and he ate his way out to survival, which is why he's ranked number 19 in the world by Major League Eating. The David Blaine of the bowel. the evil Knievel of the alimentary canal, the Houdini of cuisine, Crazy Legs Cutter! He is a teacher from Oxford, Massachusetts. He ate 30 and one half hot dogs and buns in his first contest ever. Let me hear it for Jeffrey Esper. From Chicago, Illinois, 23 slug burgers, 25 hot dogs and buns, 66 pierogi, and 180 gyoza. Ranked number 10 in the world. Let me hear it for Juan Rodriguez! He is entirely committed to competitive eating. He will do whatever it takes to win. 3 days ago, he broke up with his girlfriend and euthanized his dog to leave a void of emptiness inside him that he could fill today with hot dogs and buns, ladies and gentlemen. The cannoli-eating champion of the world with 32 cannolis in 6 minutes. A marathon runner from New York City. Let's hear it for Yasser Seddon! He has eaten 30 moon pies. He can use the word dude as a noun, pronoun, verb, adverb, adjective, and exclamation. Dude, he is the beer pong champion of Phoenix, Arizona. In fact, he's the king of all bros, the scion of the house of bro. Ladies and gentlemen, son of D-Train, son of Steve Dogg, son of the Shermanator, son of Fitzmeister, son of J-Bone himself, the great Brian Dudley Dudzinski! He is the spot shrimp and fry bread and sweet corn eating champion of the world. And yet he is most proud of his Scandinavian heritage, which he celebrates by shopping at IKEA, driving a Volvo, and cooking on a Viking range. The number 6 ranked eater in the world who has consumed 34 hot dogs and buns. Let me hear it for the great Eric the Red Denmark! Ladies and gentlemen, the matzo ball and green bean and donut eating champion of the world. Are you ready? He is the top gurgitator extraordinaire, the one who eats to the beat with the flash affair. Each out of house, a home, no thought or care, fridge empty, cupboards bare. The one that rips snacks out of school backpack, looking over your shoulder like Michael Jackson. He'll be there, eating like Pac-Man, digging in your candy dish. Yo, it's a rap song. Yo, who be there? Badlands, baby, no ifs, ands, or maybe, devour like crazy. He's like the dog in the Looney Tune, baby. He gets the steak, he's like, what? No gravy? Superhero with a fork and spoon. Train like X-Men in the danger room. Like a pirate, lower the Epicurean boom. Quicker than soon, masticating like Doom. Ladies and gentlemen, Badlands Booker! Inches tall, 200 pounds, 32 years of age. He is ranked number 7 in the world. He is the Rouse's crawfish eating champion of the world. He ate 36 dozen oysters down at Acme Oyster House. Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it for the man who can eat 33 hot dogs and buns, Adrian Morgan! He was born outside of time, a witness to all possible realities. He was there when the sea and the sky were mixed together as one, and humans floated from the depths of the Pacific to the very edge of space, where they looked out at the stars in the blackness. He was there when druids walked the earth, and he watched as mankind built great cities, developed technology, and invented complex language with combination words such as bromance, labradoodle, manscaping, frenemy, and craptacular. One man has witnessed it all, and of all time, and of all realities, this is his favorite here in Coney Island. Let's hear it for the man of mystery, the number two eater in the world, right behind his arch rival Joey Chestnut, a man who he has beaten many times. The bacon and birthday cake and frozen yogurt and gyro and Twinkie and slug burger and pumpkin pie eating champion of the world. 56 hot dogs and buns in 10 minutes. Many believe he is the future of the sport. Matthew Stoddard! You know what this means? In a world of nothing, of barren hills and cracked earth, and once proud oceans drained to sand, there will still be a monument to our existence, bleached by the sun perhaps, and blunted by time, but everlasting. Because this man represents all that is eternal in the human experience. The courage to stand for a nation when all others fail or turn away. The strength to recognize the value of freedom and to accept its cost, no matter how great. Through the curtain of the aurora, a comet blazes to herald his arrival. And his victories shall be transcribed into every language known to history, including Klingon. Number one eater in the world, I give you America itself, Joey Chestnut!
Out here in the fields, I fight for my meals. I get my back into my living.
Let's get the bonnets up here.
So we are getting ready for the contest. The eaters are ready, and we'll be right back.
You know, you're right, Jen. They were friends.
We were friends!
Gonna take 100%. Joey, he brings 100% to Coney Island. You know, he is at his best on the 4th of July. It is where he has built his legacy, and it's gonna take a really good day for me. I know he's gonna be on his game.
Number 9 would be awesome. It's unprecedented in pretty much any sport. Anybody to be able to get 9 in a row. It's crazy that I've been able to hold it down. I haven't had any ridiculously bad days. Made my body work for me on the 4th of July whenever I need to, and I'm just hoping I can do it one more time.
Is this the day that the championship changes? Here are the rules for the Nathan's Famous Hot Dog Eating Contest. 10 limits, that's what we're 10 minutes counting down from. Your dunking can't exceed 5 seconds. Now, let's go back up to the stage. Here's Melanie.
Last year on this very stage, Joey Chestnut proposed to his longtime girlfriend and eating coach, Nestle. They have since parted ways and broken up, but he does have a familiar face in his corner today, his brother, Willie. And keep in mind, guys, he's never lost a competition with Willie in his corner. Meanwhile, none of that means a thing to Matt Stoney. When I talked to him earlier this week, he said, my focus is on one thing and one thing only. That's Joey Chestnut. He said, not to sound arrogant, but Joey and I are in a league of our own. He's my only competition out there today, guys. So looking forward to a tough battle to the end between these two.
So here we go. We're moving to the start of the 2015 Nathan's Famous Hot Dog Contest. 10 minutes to go. Here's George.
Are you ready? Brooklyn, are you ready? It's go time. Count it down with me from 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
The contest is on her way. Joey Chestnut, Matt Stoney, they are the key to this competition.
It's amazing. Stoney coming out straight with two hot dog meats. Joey looks to be a little bit ahead. This is going to be a big event, Paul.
It's interesting that here at the start, you're seeing some other names come in there. Chestnut now has four, Stoney three. We expect them to pull away quickly.
Yeah, definitely, definitely. I am so pumped for this contest, Paul. If we were texting rather than actually speaking, I would send you two firecracker emojis, an American flag emoji, a birthday cake emoji, another American flag emoji, and to top it off, clapping hands. That's how stoked I am for this battle. This will be the best battle we've seen on this stage since about 2006.
Hey, I come back with a smile, though, I'm telling you. As we watch Stoney, he has the lead. 9 right now for Chestnut as they move back and forth. Joey Chestnut defeated Kobayashi head-to-head 3 straight years. And now he looks for his 9th win here at the Nathan.
Unbelievable. 11 hot dogs after just a minute. You know, Affleck's somewhere in Brooklyn searching for his third Jennifer. It took Joey just about a minute to get to that third plate. He looks comfortable, but Stoney is right behind him.
Stoney with 12, Chestnut one ahead at 13. Last year, it was 56 for Stoney. That's a personal best. He's going to have to do better than that today. They still run neck and neck, Chestnut and Stoney. Let's go to Melanie.
15 for Joey Chestnut, 16 for Matt Stoney.
Well, guys, when I spoke to Joey earlier this week, he stressed to me the importance of finding his rhythm. He said, I'll know right off the bat if it's going to be a good day or not. If I've downed 12 hot dogs in the first minute or 20 in 2 minutes, I'll know I'm off to a good pace. So at this point, they're at about 18 each, a little over 2 minutes in. Looks like a pretty solid pace.
It is running neck and neck, Stoney and Chestnut. Nobody else is in this game.
That is a 9 DPM right there. I worry a little bit about Stoney. I mean, he's keeping pace, but those hot dogs are wobbling around a bit like Steph Curry's mouthpiece. Steph had the room to fool around, play a little bit, but, you know, Stoney's got to remember he is going up against the legitimate best in the world in Joey Chestnut. He's got to maintain control.
Yeah, but consider the changing of the guard. Joey's numbers have been coming down while Stoney's has been going up.
Yes.
22 for Stoney. Chestnut, 21. They stay close. Stoney is one ahead. Actually, about a half dog when you look at the timing.
Great stuff out of these two top eaters. But, you know, we talked about youth at the top of the show. There's one of the guys, Gideon Oji, a Nigerian. He was a Clayton State basketball player. He's 6'9", and that height helped him on the basketball court. But that height is a detriment here on the Coney Island stage, because if you think about it, Stoney's just 5'8". So Oji has to go to he's got 13 more inches to get to the stage, to get to the plate.
Max, he's done is 16 dogs and buzz. Back to the battle for the lead. Stoney has 28. Chestnut has fallen a little bit behind. Is this maybe Stoney's day?
I don't know if I'd say he's pulling away just yet, and we know what Chestnut is capable of in the final minutes. We're just getting warm here today.
You look at the dogs per minute count above each of the names. Stoney is in there, 7.91, drops off to 8.4.
There's the big man, the bad man, Eric Badlands, Booker, Grandmaster, flash of corned beef hash.
He finished ninth last year with 32 hot dogs and buns. 4 minutes are now complete in competition. Stoney has the lead by one. He's maintained in that lead position for the past, say, 45 seconds or so.
I'm looking at the leaderboard. I don't know what just happened to Adrian Morgan. He absolutely disappeared. Like Stallone in Rambo 2, this kid's cut the cord. He's gone rogue. Adrian Morgan is nowhere to be found.
But you see, there's really no difference between the rest of the field and these two. There's Eater X.
Eater X, just a fixture out here in Coney Island. He may not be Joey or Stoney today, but he has the technique and discipline that a coach would love. It's two meats in one hand, the bun in the other. He puts the meats in his mouth, one to the left, one to the right. He dunks the bun. It has the twin benefit of dunking and wetting the bun while he's chewing down the food.
Eater X last year finished third, 10th straight year in competition. Right now, Stoney up there to 7.5, 7.3 dog pace, 37 dogs. Wow. You look at Chestnut, he's just a little down from that pace.
Joey is going, though. He's fighting through it. You know, we learned that he did not indeed marry his fiancée, which might have been an emotional challenge for him, but you know, he seemed to be strong coming into this event, and he's, you know, 39 hot dogs and just over 5 minutes is nothing to sneeze at.
That could cut both ways. Plus, he's got his brother helping him out.
He does have his brother helping him out. And you know what? I think he's carrying himself beautifully. He knows he's got to come in here, try to win his ninth. And yes, he's a single man. And it's back to flirting with the girls of Panera Bread after this competition.
Well past the halfway now. 14 minutes, 17 seconds to go. Stoney with 41. Now three ahead, just pulling away from Chestnut. But these next couple of minutes really will make the key difference.
It is. It just depends if Stoney can keep pace. And you remember last year, Stoney was ahead for a good amount of the competition, but then his DPM fell toward the final minutes, and that's what he's got to watch. He knows that. He's a student of the game. He's been watching his tapes.
When you think about Stoney, it's his fifth straight year here. All he's ever seen is Chestnut win. Now he knows he has a chance. Melanie?
Well, when I spoke with Matt Stoney earlier this week, he talked about his following. It's growing and growing on YouTube and Twitter. And he says just the thought of letting those people down absolutely makes him cringe. Lots of pressure on him today, guys. He's feeling it, but he said he feels different today. Something's different, and he's in the lead.
Chestnut is most certainly not out of this game. As you see the dog per minute count drop further and further down. Chestnut just two behind Joey.
Chestnut using his elbow there earlier to move that belly. That stomach of his, that stomach is beautiful, Paul. It's a majestic stomach like Tom Brady's footballs, whether inflated, deflated, segregated, or castigated. That stomach is consecrated. I'm not giving up on Joey Chestnut just yet. Lots of eating to go.
6.8 to 6.5 on the dog per minute. Stoney notches yet another one, 48. Chestnut, 46.
Stoney masticating, just breaking that down into the hot dog and bun into nutraceutical form with Sam Barkley of the IFOCE looking on.
Of course, when you see the dogs per minute come up, you just do the multiplication by 10. Of course, it varies. It gives you an idea of where they might end up at the end of this day. 2 minutes and 30 seconds left to go.
Very, very tight here, under 3 minutes. Half a dog is the DPM difference right now. You know, we mentioned Rambo earlier, and I think it's fitting because both of these men want what John Rambo wanted, and that's for American to love him as much as he loves it. Joey Chestnut loves America. Matt Stoney loves America. And with each bite and swallow of hot dog, they are proving that affection to the thousands here in Coney Island who are gathered for what's looking to be a historic competition.
Matt and Joey continue to slow. 53 for Matt Stoney. Chestnut is at 50. There's just under 2 minutes to go.
Yeah, it's very tight. Now, Joey's going to kick it in. This is where Joey plays hard. Last 2 minutes of the competition, everyone knows that. Any student of the game, even a casual observer of competitive eating, knows that Joey is killer in the last 2 minutes.
The pace remains in favor of Stoney right now. Chestnut at 6.2, 52 dogs to Stoney's 55. A minute and 30.
These two men are cut from heroic cloth, American cloth, sourced in China, sewn in Honduras, but 100% American cloth. These two brave men, 50-50 the cloth because it stands more washings, but really great Americans, and they're going after those hot dogs today.
coming up to 1 minute to go in this great 4th of July tradition at the corner of Surf and Stillwell in Brooklyn. 1 minute, counting down now.
I just saw the commissioner looking on from the pit there. He's an even-handed man. He's not given to creating scandals where none exist just to cover up his own failings. So hungry Charles Hardy in the pit watching the final minute. It's going to be a tight one.
The pacing still remains with Stoney. 6.19, 5.96 for Chestnut. About 30 seconds left to go. Chestnut is three behind.
Paul, I think this kid is going to do it. This would be a huge upset. This would be Nova over Georgetown in 85. This would be the Pats over the Rams in Super Bowl 36. Youth is speaking in Coney Island today. Will Matt Stoney become the Jordan Spieth of tubed beef?
We talked about the possibility. I'm not sure that I was believing it, but Stoney is at 60. We have under 10 seconds to go. They count down. Now 5 seconds.
What's in the mouth counts.
So they both are struggling to keep what's in the mouth in the mouth. The competition is now done, and it appears that Matt Stoney is our new champion.
Well, Chestnut just flipped to 60. This is unofficial, but that was an incredible battle of two incredible athletes. God.
What a day, what a change. One star ascending, the other declining. Is that the way it is?
It was a fantastic competition. I can never say that that man on the screen would decline with a 60-some-odd hot dog performance.
It also is pretty amazing to me that how fast they pull away from the entire rest of the field.
Well, it's funny. Those are the best eaters in the world up there, right? I mean, you know, Crazy Legs Conti was up there. We didn't even get there.
That is the unofficial count. 62 for Stoney, Chestnut with 60, and then Janis, he's way down there with 35.
Yeah, Janis is spectacular host for Major League Eating. Like the Davis Love of our sport. You hardly see him up top anymore. To determine
the outcome. Man, what a day. Judges doing their final checks now. Talking to each of the judges on the ground, but that man on the right, Matt Stoney, may have just upset Joey Chestnut. Chestnut with
The body language, Paul, may have given that. Unbelievable moment in Coney Island.
You can see Matt Stoney struggling. Joey Chestnut. The idea of loss settling now on his mind.
Fantastic American and a great eater.
He expected so much out of the day. He expected nine straight wins.
Anyone who's a fan of sport.
I saw him earlier today and last night. He's confident. He's ready to go. What an upset.
I'm just checking now for Sam Barclay.
We're waiting for the official results now. Final check with the judges.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 10 minutes of the most wrenching competition I have ever seen, one of these eaters had 62 hot dogs and buns, and one of these eaters had 60 hot dogs and buns. The 2015 Nathan's Famous 4th of July champion of the world, Matthew Stoney!
Amazing moment. In sports.
He has dethroned the king. The boy king has dethroned the boy king. Ladies and gentlemen, with 60 hot dogs and buns, Joey Chestnut, how are you feeling? What happened out there?
I just had trouble. I was slow and he was eating fast and I couldn't catch him.
Ladies and gentlemen, always gracious, Matt Stoney. No one thought it could happen when Joey Chestnut beat Kobayashi and then beat him again and then beat him again. No one thought anyone could beat the great Joey Chestnut, the number one ranked eater in the world. What happened out there? How'd you do it?
Oh, this is surreal. I trained hard for this. This is absolutely amazing. To win on the sport's biggest stage is crazy.
Incredible. Ladies and gentlemen, the champion of the world!
The crowd loving every minute of it.
And so it happened.
as the championship changes. And now Matt Stoney has won the Nathan's Hot Dog Eating Contest for 2015. We'll talk to him in a moment. So there they are, the final results. These are official as Matt Stoney takes the win over Joey Chestnut. Let's go to Melanie.
Thank you, guys. Joey, after 8 straight years on top, what happened out there today?
I don't know. Damn. No, I just didn't find my rhythm, and he was eating. I can't take anything away from him. He ate 62 hot dogs, and I did bad. He deserved the win, and it gives me a reason to definitely come back next year. I've been looking for a competition for a long time, and now I have it, and now he's made me hungry.
You mentioned to George you were having trouble out there today. What was it? Was it the consistency of the hot dogs?
The hot dogs, they're some really cold, leathery ones, but they're the same for everybody, and there's no excuse. I just didn't find my rhythm, and I'm just happy for him. I'm happy to be here.
All right, George, I'm going to send it to you for the trophy ceremony.
Ladies and gentlemen, Joey Chestnut, one of the greatest champions of all time, but we have a new champion here today with 62 Nathan's Famous Hot Dogs and Buns, the young man from San Jose, California, Matthew Stoney. He's got the trophy now.
All right, Matthew, you've dethroned the champ. What's going through your mind right now?
This is crazy. You know, Joey's an amazing competitor. I know he brings 100% to the 4th of July, and he's a legend of the sport. And to beat him by a couple hot dogs this year, I trained hard for this. I can't say I came in confident, but I came prepared.
Yeah, you did come in confident. And you told me earlier this week something was different about this year. Something felt different. You were more prepared. What was different this year?
I've just had an amazing year so far. You know, we work hard for this, and my body was working for me this year.
Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
Ladies and gentlemen.
ESPN's presentation of the 2015 Nathan's Hot Dog Eating Contest is brought to you by Nathan's Famous Hot Dogs. Enter the selfie sweepstakes today. So the guard has changed. Right now, the name is Stoney at the top of the order. We hope you've enjoyed the time here today. We hope you have a great and safe 4th of July. And once again, congratulations to the new winner, Matt Stoney. He's taken the win away from that man, Joey Chestnut.
Are you going in the water or aren't you? Huh? Angela, I am waiting for an answer. Yes or no? God damn it, answer me, Angela, answer me! God damn it, answer me!
What the hell's going on here?
Oh, bitch won't answer me, she never answers me!
Side scenario.
So that's it then?
Yeah, for now.
Lenny couldn't find his ass with both hands. Explain to me how he could possibly pull this off. Is he a fucking magician or something?
Mackenzie.
Just try to calm down, honey, okay?
Sweetheart, I think it's time for you to go home and get some rest. We'll take it from here.
You don't believe anything I've told you.
Hey, that was dope, eh?
Straight out of Compton. How you go from selling rocks in a dope house to eating dinner in the White House?
Our art is a reflection of our reality. I'm coming straight out of Compton.
With a split hot dog and kettle-cooked potato chips on a fresh-baked bun, it's the most American thick burger. Only at Carl's Jr. and Hardee's.
We've all come face to face with doubt. But today, there's no time for maybes.